Hey guys, welcome back. I'm Kanai, and today I'm going to be showing to you some fantastic riding gear material. It came in with Armour, especially. It came in with my jacket, which I got from the US. It's called Icon Merc Deployed, a fantastic brand, very premium quality equipment, and for damn cheap. So I got the entire jacket with this superb material for just 12,000 in India. So yeah, much cheaper than DSG and everything, and way cheaper than buying the same brand in India through a dealer. Right, but what this video is specifically about is this material called D3O. Now this is basically a shoulder pad for my jacket that is supposed to, you know, provide me a lot of impact protection if ever I have a crash. So far I have had multiple crashes with multiple riding gears, and never has any jacket, or for that matter Armour, impressed me a lot until I found this. So basically, what is this D3O? D3O is a patented product. It was basically designed for impact sports like ice hockey, you have skiing and everything, where any sort of impact could result in serious damage, bone injury and everything. So it was designed there, but very soon it was adopted into the motorcycling riding gear. In fact, it is a 10-year-old technology. However, no Indian manufacturer offers this in their, you know, riding gear. This comes as standard when you buy Icon. It's a very great material, very flexible if you can see. So for a elbow pad, if you've seen a DSG elbow pad or, you know, a pro biker jacket elbow pad, you've seen that it's a very hard ABS plastic type of material. This on the other hand is literally like foam, right? You can bend it, you can hold it like this, you can, it does all, it's very flexible, very light. When you're wearing it with the jacket, you never feel that there's armor in your jacket. You'll never feel that, you know, you have some really hard pieces inside your jacket to protect you from impact. However, like I said, this is a magic material, right? So it is very soft if I'm using it gently. But the moment I use a lot of pressure on it, or it faces a lot of impact, it becomes very, very hard. You know, sort of like oobleck. Oobleck, if you've ever done the school experiments where you mix cornstarch and water, and if you gently push your finger inside, it will slowly dip, right? But if I hit it with my finger, it will just become hard, way harder than plastic also. In fact, this material can get so hard that it can easily, right, you know, deflect a pellet gunshot. So it's that good. So I'll just show you a quick test of what this material is like, you know, where to buy it, and how it really works. So this is my elbow guard. This is my back protector from the jacket. As you can see, again, this is also extremely flexible, right? It's basically like a thick piece of cloth and very, very light. So you can bend it in as many ways as possible. It works perfectly fine. But the moment the moment there's a lot of impact on it, it will work just like a hard piece of plastic. So for this test, what I'll do is I'm going to smack this stick on my hand, right? But with this material on, and you'll instantly know how much protection this thing can give. So let's get started. I'll just show you what kind of strength I'm going to be using. So you know, it is a real test. You believe me? Check this out. I'm going to be hitting it exactly with this kind of force. Now, just by the sound of it, it's pretty scary. And I'm sure if it was my finger there, it would have definitely broken a bone or something. But now I'm going to do the same hit with this armor on my palm, and you'll see that there's little to no damage. And I'll also tell you after the test how this basically works. So I'm going to keep this elbow guard on my palm, and I'm going to smack it with the stick again. So check it out. Now I have my hand here. Right? Absolutely no damage, but if I hit it, right? So what this equipment is basically doing is it becomes very hard at the point of impact right then and there, and the hardness, sort of all the molecules sort of get together, that forms a very rigid structure, and instantly the entire pressure, if I hit it here, if I hit it in the center, the entire pressure is going to spread across the armor and slowly press onto my hand. So I will not have pressure at one point. It's going to spread across the entire area, and it will also absorb most of the impact because it is like foam. So if I hit it with, let's say, 10 units of force, so you know, it's going to absorb 2 units of force, the other 8 units are evenly going to spread, and eventually probably my elbow will have only half a unit of force on the entire elbow. So it's great for impact protection. I'm surprised why none of the motorcycle gear manufacturers like DSG, Pro Biker are using this. It's a 10-year-old technology. It's very common in most of the riding gear outside of India. And it's very easy to find it in India as well through a few dealers. Or you can directly import it from other websites like FC Moto, MotoWin, etc. So yeah, check it out. Before you buy a riding gear, it's not just the jacket that you're buying. In fact, the protection is even more important. If you are riding on a, let's say, Pulsar 220 and you're using a DSG, you can easily keep the same jacket but swap your protectors with the D3O armor kit. It's a little expensive as compared to your standard ABS plastic armor, but it is way thinner, way more flexible, way more light, way more strong when it is time to be strong. So it has all the right features at the right time, at the right places, and I'll definitely recommend it. However, be sure that you check, buy only the original armor. Like if you go to Pro Biker Pune, you will find a lot of foam pads, literally foam pads, that have the same color, but they are not D3O. It's just a foam pad for the same price, right? So make sure you see this little D3O written on it. It's got its own patent and everything. It's a patented product. It's slightly expensive, but it will definitely be worth it the day you crash, right? So check it out. If you have any other questions regarding this equipment, just drop me a comment. I'll be sure, you know, I'll just answer your question in a day or two. You can also import this gear. If you are really interested in importing gear, please subscribe to my channel. My next video is going to be about how to import quality riding gear from other countries and for much cheaper than Indian MRPs. So if you are interested, subscribe. My next video will be coming up tomorrow. I'll give you a full detailed method on how to import riding gear, where to buy it from, what is the process, what are the shipping charges, what are the custom duties, are there any ways to evade the duty, etc. All of that, right? So stay tuned for my next video. I hope you find this material on the internet. I'll also be putting up, following this video, I'll put up a small video of this material resisting a gunshot, so you really know what this is capable of. And hope you have a good time. Enjoy riding. I'm sure corona scene is fucked up right now, but all bikers are itching to get out on the streets and for long rides. So see you on the next video. Please share and subscribe if you like it. Bye.